Today's Ask Me Anything goes out to Evan from Sydney, Australia, who says, love your channel. I'm a big fan. I have a 2-year-old Irish Terrier bred for hunting, vermin control, and guarding. He's a magnificent dog, but intense. Well, that's why you have an Irish Terrier. I put a lot of time into training into him and is very engaged, responsive, and obedient. But on our farm, if he sees a kangaroo, it's very hard to make him stop the chase, but never catches the roo. I don't think he would. If he did, he'd have a big problem. And returns after about a minute to my dog whistle. I use the stop command around home, which works fine with the tug toy, etc., but I can call him off toys and food. But when he sees a running animal, me yelling stop is enough. So I stop yelling stop right now. Do you think it's possible to correct this? I try to avoid him seeing the roos, but that's hard in Australia. Wouldn't e-collar work? Yes, that's going to be the only thing that's going to work for this dog, because you got a high drive dog, and you're going to have to give him a very, very firm correction on the e-collar to block that prey drive. And what I would try to do is kind of simulate that prey drive at a distance. Use a long line in the beginning, so that we're, you know, or a long flexi lead, so that he knows that when he sees that animal and he feels that shock, the safe zone is to come back to you. Because if you shock him and he keeps going, you're going to keep shocking him. He's going to think you're shocking him, and his goal is going to be to get away from you, and that's going to screw up the training. I've seen people do that. I've had to fix that on clients' dogs. And at some point, I'll do an e-collar course on my membership section that will kind of address these things. But yeah, you're going to need to use an e-collar to protect your dogs. If a kangaroo gets hold of him, it's going to kill him. Got a question? Ask me anything.